tomorrow will be filled with wondrous things. What about life? Your life and mine. Will we change? Will we be happier? You know, some persons contend that the drama of daily life remains constant and will remain so forever. I wonder. Perhaps together we can find a clue to the answer on tonight's Tales of Tomorrow.
Better hope they are, Brennick.
Oh? What does that mean?
You know very well. We were due here 15 days ago. With the safari and the supplies.
I see. I suppose it's my fault.
Yes.
The bearers deserted us.
Yes. All your fault. As a guide, you ought to know how to handle your men. But you were vicious, inhuman toward them. I don't blame them in the least for deserting us. And what's more, when we get back to civilization, I'm going to press charges against you.
Are you now, really?
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you something. When we get back to civilization, there'll be charges pressed. Only it'll be I who'll do the pressing. When I'm finished, you'll see every last deserter strung up to the highest scaffold in Manaus. That I promise. Oi! Oi! And a move on! Get a move on!
Cobb! Isn't it enough you've got him carrying your gear, too?
Well, here's the crater.
Tom! Susan!
They were here. They'd have answered long ago.
We only had food enough for 10 days at the most. I hope we're not too late.
Well, there's one way to find out for sure. Tell you, plenty of food. They're probably waiting for us on the boat this very minute. Let's get going.
No, we'll spend the night here.
Why?
Because it's still 6 long miles to the river.
We can cover that in a couple of hours.
No, the boy is completely exhausted, and so am I. We'll spend the night here.
All right. Hello? What is it?
I haven't the faintest idea.
Looks like a dried out watermelon.
If it were 100 times smaller, I'd almost think it was a cocoon.
A cocoon?
This is strange. Specimens of the meteorite, papers, notes, instruments, they're all here. Plankton would never leave these things here.
Perhaps they decided to travel light.
Never. Not Blanford. He'd have given up taking food to save space for these specimens.
What's your theory?
They must still be here. Somewhere. What is it? It's Pine Trip. Tom Pierce.
Well, they couldn't have died of starvation.
There was plenty of food. They didn't die of starvation. Their throats are pierced. Some giant leech of an animal has drained them of every drop of blood. Where's Susan? You're safe.
Run away. Hide. There are hundreds of them. Run. Run. Hundreds of them. Tom? Uncle John? Run. Hide. There. Let me out. There.
Susan! Susan!
Tell me, Borden. Was this Professor Blankforth all right?
What do you mean?
Listen to what he says here. August 3rd, the creature died this night. Conclusion, it could not have been of earthly origin. By some miracle, the meteorite brought it here. A sample of life beyond our universe in the form of a monstrous, invisible... Invisible. Insect. Now, I ask you.
Where'd you find her?
Over there.
Let me see it. Why, it's... Blankford's diary. July 23. Pearson discovered a gigantic cocoon this morning at the crater side. 3 hours later in the work hut, the cocoon released a fully developed... Invisible Amago. Roughly the size of a large dog. We managed to subdue the creature and found it securely. Since the creature is invisible, we have no way of determining its shape or form. Pearson suggests that we chloroform it and make a plaster cast of it. That way we'd have a solid dimensional figure. July 23, evening. The plaster model is finished. It is the most dreadful insect I have ever seen.
My, my. The cocoon released an invisible insect about the size of a large dog.
July 28th. This morning I discovered what the creature feeds on. Its exclusive nutriment is human blood. Which would account for the manner of their deaths. Well, there must be a plaster model of it somewhere around here.
I'll lay a 10 to 1 you'll never find it.
Thank you.
He's dead. His throat was dead.
Did you see anything?
I saw nothing. Yet I know. I know something was there.
Run away, Hart. There are hundreds of them. Hundreds of them.
Stories you see and hear on Tales of Tomorrow are about people who face strange and unexplainable problems. These stories are created by those whose curiosity about the future and about the universe around us is vivid and compelling. Many of the situations in which the characters find themselves may seem improbable, but are they impossible? Nobody really knows. We do know that the universe that surrounds us is an enormous mystery. Our stories try to break through the barrier of life as we know it to discover in our imaginations what life beyond may be like.
After you left here, what happened?
We hid ourselves in a cave. We waited. We waited for you to arrive. Then the food we'd taken with us was all gone. Uncle John went out to find some more. It was night. Tom and I were asleep. We didn't even know he'd left. Then Tom went after him.
We're foolish for staying here. We should make a run for it.
Mr. Gordon, please don't leave me.
Oh, no, of course I won't, Susan.
Miss, you've got to tell me. Is it true that there are invisible things like that outside?
Yes. Yes, it's true. You can't see them, but they're there. Waiting. Oh, it's waiting. Right, you can hear them. Hundreds of them. Scratching, growling, trying to get in.
Oh, no, Susan, Susan. Hasn't she been through enough? What about me? Do you think I liked this? If they're invisible, how do we know they're not in here already? Well, there are dozens of places right in this room where they could be hiding.
Room, Brannigan. I'm sure we'd know about it by now.
Oh, really? I'm not taking any chances. They're just waiting for us. Biding the time.
Susan, we'll be here all night. I feel sure we're perfectly safe, but if you want, I can give you a sedative.
I don't want to sleep. I don't ever want to sleep.
Thank you.
out there. There must be dozens out there. We'll never be able to get out of here.
What is it? They've started again.
Now, don't worry, Susan. We're absolutely safe.
Oh, no, we're not. I told you we should have made a run for it.
Well, nobody stopped you.
Look, one second way in.
Brannigan, hurry. Barricade that hole. Susan, over here, quickly.
It's in the room.
They're in here. We can't see them. But they're in here somewhere.
Look for any sign of motion. Keep your eyes on everything. If you even think you see something move, fire.
Help me! Stop! It's choking me!
Doing without sleep. You take the first shift. I'll wake you up in 2 hours.
But there are hundreds of those creatures out there.
I don't care. I'll take my chance.
Brannigan! Brannigan, come back here! Brannigan! Get away from me! Get away!
Incredible, but then why not? After all, they are insects. Now look, there's a whole crate of them here. Suit! It's our only chance. We'll each carry as many of these bombs as we can. We'll release a constant spray as we go. Even if it doesn't kill them, it'll stop them from following. With luck, we should make the river by morning. Come on, Suit.
I can't told you, Father.
All right. You'll rest a while. When you get to Manaus, you'll inform the authorities. They'll send down a fleet of planes and spray this entire area. Please. Look. The river.
Oh, Uncle John.
Come on, Susan.
Earth. Is there life in the universe? Nobody really knows. But it is possible that in the space beyond us, there is life. That there are other suns giving warmth and life to worlds like ours. In the years, in the ages, in the eons ahead, we may find the answer to our questions. We may find that in the space beyond us, beyond the stars, there are worlds with life far richer than our own. Tales of Tomorrow speculates about such a future. Next week, same time, same station, another gripping story on Tales of Tomorrow.